الحمد لله رب العالمين، الحمد لله تعالى، نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه، ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. Indeed, all praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our Lord, the gracious, the merciful, the master of the earths and the heavens, the king of the day of judgment, Azza wa Jal. And the prayers and the blessings of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and be upon all those who follow in the footsteps of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الله تعالى به الغمة وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على الحبيب المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن استنى بسنته وسار على هديه إلى يوم الدين. Indeed, we bear witness that there is no Lord but the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the messenger of Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's peace and blessings be upon our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I remind myself and remind you to be pious, to remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in everything that you do, to heed and follow the orders of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he says, عز وجل يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله ولتنظر نفس ما قدمت لغد واتقوا الله إن الله خبير بما تعملون. Oh, who you believe, be God conscious and die in no way except in the way of Islam. Oh, who you believe, be God conscious and let every soul be aware of its own tomorrow. And be God conscious, for He knows best what you do. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive our sins, to guide our steps, to instill taqwa in our hearts, and to keep our feet steadfast. Allahumma ameen. My dear respected brothers and sisters, one of the most important reminders for every one of us is to remember to remain steadfast on the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all want to be engaged in da'wah. We want to do that which is asked of us and required of us, and we're encouraged to do, and we're required to do in many other respects. But the fact of the matter is that getting to the Jannah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires steadfastness, requires hard work, requires those to remain with their eye on the prize. أَحَسِبَ النَّاسُ أَن يُتْرَكُوا أَن يَقُولُوا آمَنَّا وَهُمْ لَا يُفْتَنُونَ. Do you think people would be left to their own to say that we believe without them being tested? وَلَقَدْ فَتَنَّا. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would test those to see their righteousness and to see their iman. And so if we were to heed an advice more important, then we should heed the advice of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When a man came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَسَأَلَهُ قُلْ لِي فِي الْإِسْلَامِ قَوْلٌ لَا أَسْأَلُ أَحَدٌ بَعْدَهُ فَقَالَ لَهُ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, قُلْ آمَنْتُ بِاللَّهِ ثُمَّ اسْتَقِمْ. He said, O Prophet of Allah, tell me a saying in Islam that I don't have to ask anybody else anything more. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told him, say that I believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Reaffirm your faith. ثُمَّ اسْتَقِمْ. Then remain steadfast on that path. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed the verse in Surah Hud to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعَكَ وَلَا تَطْغَوْا إِنَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ بَصِيرٌ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam يسأله أبو بكر رضي الله عنه يوما, يقول له شبت يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم، فيرد عليه صلى الله عليه وسلم فيقول شيبتني هود وأخواتها. فيسأله الصحابة ما الذي في هود شيبك يا رسول الله، أو كما سألوه، فيقول صلى الله عليه وسلم بهذه الآية: فاستقم كما أمرت ومن تاب معك ولا تطغوا إنه بما تعملون بصير. ابن عباس رضي الله عنه كان يقول أنه ما نزلت آية على الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم، أقرأ النص، أشد على الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم من هذه الآية. That there has not been a verse that has been revealed in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that affected the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم or that has been heavy on him than this verse. And Ibn Abbas continues to say, فيقول صلى الله عليه وسلم بعدها شمروا شمروا ولم يرى بعدها ضاحكا صلى الله عليه وسلم. قول ابن عباس في هذه الآية، رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم، الله سبحانه وتعالى orders him to remain steadfast the way he was ordered صلى الله عليه وسلم. Not the way he chooses to do. Not the way that he feels he is up to. Not the way that he allows to happen just by letting it go. Many a times when we look at the verse in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that says, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها. We say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does not prescribe upon us except that which we can do. But we don't think of it from the position of strength. We think of it from the position of weakness. We want to give ourselves a pass by saying that we will do everything that we can. Not to challenge ourselves to achieve our full potential. Whereas the true meaning of this verse is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high, who created man and who knows what man is capable with if he follows the divine guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he is capable of carrying this mission that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala presented to the mountains and to the heavens, and they refused to take it. And man was given it, but man was given the abilities to carry and conduct this mission of da'wah of Allah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when we say, لا يكلف الله نفسا إلا وسعها, then we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that we are capable of carrying this mission of the prophets. We are capable of carrying the mission of لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. But we have to figure out the ways by which we are able to do this. So when the Prophet ﷺ was given the order by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to remain steadfast the way he was ordered, he recognized sallallahu alayhi wa sallam what a heavy burden this responsibility is. And when we see in Surah Ash-Shura also, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلِذَلِكَ فَدْعُوا وَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتُ وَقُلْ آمَنْتُ بِمَا أَنْزَلَ اللَّهُ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَأُمِرْتُ لِأَعْدِلَ بَيْنَكُمْ. We see here that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and when we look and when we read about the concept of istiqama, to remain steadfast on the path that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prescribed for mankind, we recognize that it's not just about personal straightforwardness and personal improvement, but it is a chain that leads to one another. It's a personal realm, but it's also a public realm. Because the verb qawama, which is the root word of the word istiqama, is to fix that which is crooked, to straighten that which is not straight. And so it goes from within, but it also applies without. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in so many places, would describe what we do with the faith of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with the guidance, قُلْ إِنَّمَا أَنَا بَشَرٌ مِثْلُكُمْ يُوحَى إِلَيَّ أَنَّمَا إِلَهُكُمْ إِلَهٌ وَاحِدٌ فَاسْتَقِيمُوا إِلَيْهِ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوهُ. Then there is a personal aspect to it where you have to straighten yourself. You have to remain in a constant state of not only ta'a, but to remain vigilant about your ta'a and remain vigilant about ensuring that you're calling others to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But then there's also وَإِنَّ هَذَا صِرَاطِ مُسْتَقِيمًا فَاتَّبِعُوهُ وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا السُّبُلَ فَتَفَرَّقَ بِكُمْ عَنْ سَبِيلِهِ. That this is a path that we take into this life. We, every time we pray, every time we recite Surah Al-Fatiha, we say اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Oh Allah, guide us to the straight path, the path that is صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمْ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمْ. So on and so forth. We describe this path, and we know it's a path that takes proactive action from us to comply with. So when we think of the concept of istiqamah, we have to start from within. We have to recognize that until and unless we follow the guidance of this deen without allowing our own hawa to pull us apart and without allowing our shubuhat to cloud on us this path, then we can't begin the journey of implementing the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and living His divine mission. So there is a divine guidance that helps all of us to achieve their potential, that helps all of us and inspires us and directs us to achieve our full potential. Believing in the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not just a luxury, it is a must, it's a necessity. It's not a job that we do just in the masjid and then we leave it behind when we leave. It's not something that we do when we engage in prayers and then we leave it in between prayers. But rather it's the very tool by which we achieve the ability to remain on the straight path at all times. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ حَسَنَةٍ فَمِنَ اللَّهِ وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ. Whatever good that comes your way comes from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whatever misgood or misdeeds come to you, they come from you. Some people misinterpret this and they think it's about the fact that as man is imperfect, that all of his actions are wrong. But the fact of the matter is that it means that whenever you follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever you stick to the divine guidance of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will always be good. That's why it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whatever good comes your way comes from you being aligned with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His orders. The minute you choose to do otherwise, the minute you derail yourself from following that guidance, you have started to commit injustice against yourself, and you will reap nothing but the wrong path that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala directs you to it. And so وَمَا أَصَابَكَ مِنْ سَيِّئَةٍ فَمِنْ نَفْسِكَ. Because you have chosen not to follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And so if we look at our deen, as we embrace it, as we engage it, we must see the change from within. We must be able to feel that this guidance not only makes us better people, but it makes us more dedicated, makes us more committed, makes us more willing to live and fulfill the divine mission that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed upon us. Because when we achieve istiqamah from within, we must use the tools of istiqamah to fix that which is without. To look at the matters of our society and be able to champion the good, fight the fight for justice, stand against transgression and injustice, ensure that righteousness and goodness is what is the dealings between human beings. And so there is a divine mission that is attached to that divine guidance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has prescribed upon us. Then the challenge before us as communities and as members and as part of a greater society to define for ourselves what is that platform through which that we can achieve that divine guidance, that divine mission, that is the outcome of the implementation of that divine guidance within our lives. That's how we can incorporate, my dear brothers and sisters, our deen and our lives around us. We can't live this binary or this divided attention to who we are as Muslims and who we are as Americans, who we are as individuals seeking the divine guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and seeking His forgiveness and seeking His Jannah and staying away from His hellfire as we do in the seasons of Ramadan and the season of Ta'at and throughout the year. When you're engaged in your abode of ibadah, that's what you're looking for. You're looking for your personal salvation. You're looking how you can stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and be forgiven your sins and be given the blessings of entering paradise. Yes, وَكُلُّكُمْ أَتِيهِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَرْدًا. لكن Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires of us a mission to be implemented in which this ibadah and this ta'ah helps us to become the individuals capable of achieving that divine mission that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires of us. That's why it has to be our business as a community and as individuals and as groups to figure out what is that divine mission. What is that platform that we must create? And my dear brothers and sisters, if you look at what we do as a community, we are working to establish that civic platform through which we can achieve that divine mission that is required of us. So when we champion social justice, we don't do it so that people can point to us and say, these people are doing good things. When we open soup kitchens, or when we deal with poverty, or when we tackle racism, or when we stand against injustice, we're not doing it so that just we can be accepted as a group of society. We're doing it because we're driven by a divine mission from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created man and gave him the Quran and gave him knowledge, what does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala most high say in Surah Ar-Rahman? Ar-Rahman, 'allama al-Quran, khalaqa al-insan, 'allamahu al-bayan, ash-shamsu wal-qamaru bihusban, wan-najmu wash-shajaru yasjudan, was-samaa'a rafa'aha wa wada'a al-mizan. Alla tatghaw fil mizan wa aqimu al wazn bil qist wa la tukhsiru al mizan. This creation of man, when he was given the Quran by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he was taught knowledge by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, most high, to whom the heavens and the stars prostrate, who created the heavens and raised them and then created man, but he was given a mission. Allah tatghaw fil mizan. Don't do the imbalance to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's order. And not only that, وَأَقِيمُ الْوَزْنَ بِالْقِسْطِ وَلَا تُخْسِرُ الْمِيزَانِ. You have to live your life in order for you to bring back the balance that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala requires of all humanity. That's why that there is no difference between our salah here in the masjid and between our service to our fellow human beings in the community. Because it is through creating that civic platform that we are able to define what our divine mission is, which must be connected to that divine guidance that is needed for us to remain steadfast on His path. And then it's a constant process of struggle until we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Most High, with His forgiveness and with His guidance. وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. And then constantly, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ أو وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ. Constancy, patience, perseverance. Then the calling to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, engaging the call to righteousness, enjoining the good and forbidding the evil, the proactive stance that we must translate into activity, my dear brothers and sisters. It's not an excuse for us not to know what to do. We must figure out what is it that we are supposed to do. We live in America, we live in 21st century America. We must figure out what are the tools of power. How do we influence? How do we change? How do we bring forth the necessary change that is a must in our society? Because it's not an excuse for us to come in the hereafter and say, oh Allah, we have seen injustice rampant in the world. We lived in the richest country in the world. We had our tools, the ability to transform and bring forth all this good and all this wealth and all this power. And yet, we felt weak. We felt that we're helpless. We felt that we can do nothing about it. That is never in the lexicon and in the vocabularies of Muslims, my dear brothers and sisters. إن تنصروا الله ينصركم. If you remain in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah will give you victory. We just need to define what those are. We need to understand what those tools are. We need to connect our divine guidance to our divine mission. And we need to translate it into an action-packed action plan and programs. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, when you see your brothers and sisters here in Darul Hijrah and the other Islamic centers and in the other community centers, planning out and figuring out what to do, then you realize that there is something more beyond than just increasing the activity or keeping ourselves busy with activity. It has to be mission-driven. It has to be driven by this and inspired by this guidance. You need to become an individual who is also mission-driven, my dear brothers and sisters. You don't live your life just so that you can do the same actions every day without a purpose, without a overarching reason why you do what you do, so that you're constantly inspired, so that you're constantly building that momentum and being able to portray it. And when you live like that, then you can no longer accept that we are part of a community that's not mission-driven. A community that recognizes the value and the pricelessness of the guidance that we have. A guidance that was sent to all of mankind. A guidance that was sent by the Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide all of humanity. For us to be the tools by which we transmit that guidance and translate it into effective change and platform within our lives. It becomes a mission for all. We become a community driven as a mission-driven community. Then we look at our leadership and we hold them accountable. We figure out for ourselves how we can best move. And so that when every one of us leaves this boundaries of this masjid, they are proactively and they're engaged and they're able to transform the society they live in. My dear brothers and sisters, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to that which is best. Inspire us to be the true carriers of this faith and to make us like our beloved sallallahu alayhi wa sallam amongst those who will remain steadfast the way they have been ordered. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه غفور رحيم. استغفر الله العظيم ورحمة الله استغفر الله العظيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. الصلاة والسلام على حبيبنا المصطفى وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My dear brothers and sisters, these words about istiqama are the very translation of every time Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala Most High would mention the word istiqama, siratum mustaqim, istaqimu. We need to be reflecting on this mission and figuring out how best are we doing it. Every time you recite Surah Al-Fatiha, when you read it, and when you read اهدنا الصراط المستقيم, don't think just of the path that we need in order for us to get to the hereafter with the remembrance and the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But that is a must and we must always think of that. But also think of yourself. What have I done in order for myself to maintain myself, my children, my family, my society, my people, my world, to remain steadfast on that path and to get to that forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is the heart and the soul of the mission that we live, and we must proactively and actively work to translate it, hoping and praying inshallah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will accept our deeds and keep us steadfast and forgive our sins and guide us. Saddidu wa qaribu wa'lamu annahu lan yanju ahadun minkum bi'amali. قالوا ولا أنت يا رسول الله قال ولا أنا إلا أن يتغمدني الله سبحانه وتعالى برحمة منه وفضلا. Indeed, forgiveness and guidance is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and forgive us. Allahumma afu anna waghfir lana warhamna. Anta maulana fansurna ala alqawm alkafirin. Allahumma ahdina wahdi bina. Allahumma ati nufusana taqwaha. Wazakkiha maulaya anta khayru man zakkaha. Anta waliyuha wa maulaha. عباد الله، إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعدكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون. وقوموا إلى الصلاة يرحمكم الله وأقم الصلاة.